Hello! The MO-200 Excel Associate exam contains several functions as part of its syllabus. In this video, I will walk you through the usage of all of them using one simple example for each of them. We will be also releasing a video for all the MO-201 Excel Expert exam. So click on subscribe and hit the bell button to get notified when that video becomes available. We will begin with the most common among them, the sum function. In the current sheet, we see the sales of various products in a span of 5 months. We want to sum the sales of chips, pens, milk and juice. In cell E11, we enter the equal sign and the function name, which in this case is sum. Then, we choose the cell area we want to sum. We can add multiple cell areas if we want. But in this example, we will only sum cells E6 to E9. We press on Enter and the result is calculated. The syntax of sum is one of the easiest in Excel. Equally easy is the widely used average function. Its purpose is pretty straightforward. It calculates the average of one or multiple cell ranges. For those with a background in statistics, average actually calculates the mean average. In this example, we have the sales of a PC hardware shop. We want to calculate the average of the cost in euro, which you can find in column E of our sheet. We navigate to cell E116 and type the equal sign followed by the function name. Then we choose the required cell range and click on Enter to see the result. As in sum, we can add multiple cell areas if we want. We will continue with the min function, which returns the minimum value inside one or multiple cell ranges. In this example, we want to calculate the minimum sales for January. Inside cell J4, we type the equal sign followed by the name of the function and the desired cell range. In this case, we use the range from D5 to D10. The opposite of the min function is the max function. It returns the maximum value inside one or multiple cell ranges. We have an almost identical worksheet as before. In this example, though, we want to find the maximum of all our sales. I know it is kind of easy when there are not that many cells to choose from, but the structure of the function remains the same no matter the size of our data. So, in cell D12, we type the equal sign followed by the function name. Then we select the cell range and hit on Enter. We can see our anticipated result. One of the most used functions in Excel is the COUNT function, which counts the number of cells inside one or multiple cell ranges. It only counts cells containing numbers though, so keep that in mind. In this example, we will count the numbers that exist in the first 6 cells of column A. In cell A8, we type the equal sign followed by the COUNT function and the cell range. In the 6 cells we are counting, there are 2 cells that contain text and 1 that is blank, so the cells that contain numbers are 3. But what if you want to count all non-empty cells, even those with text? In this case, the COUNTA function is the one to use. It has a similar syntax to the COUNT function. In this example, we will count all non-empty cells in the cell range from A3 to A1500. We hit on Enter to see our result. The obvious question now is how we count the blank cells. The answer comes in the form of the COUNTBLANK function. The syntax is again the same as the COUNT function. In this example, we count the blank cells that exist in the cell range A1 to A400. All the previous functions are very useful, But the real power of Excel is in its logical functions, and the most used of them is the IF function. In our current sheet, we have four columns of numbers. We want to compare the numbers of the first two columns for each row. If the numbers of the first column are greater than the ones in the second, then we want the numbers in column C. If not, then we want the numbers in column D. We navigate to the first row of the E column. First, we type the name of the function, followed by the equal sign. Then we type the condition. Following is the result if the condition is true, which is cell C1. And at the end is the result if the condition is false, which is cell D1. Finally, we fill column E with this function. Another great characteristic of Excel is its ability to manipulate text. There are plenty of functions to this end. There are functions that manipulate the case of the text. In the current example, we want to change the case of the text in cell A1 to uppercase, to lowercase, and to proper case. Proper case means that the first letter of each word is uppercase and all the rest lowercase. The use of the functions is pretty straightforward. For proper case, we use the function proper. For uppercase, the function upper. And for lowercase, the function lower. All the functions take one argument, which is the text we want to convert. In cells A2 to A4, we can see the functions in action. The function LEN returns the length of a text. In the current sheet, we want to calculate the length of the strings. We type the equal sign, followed by the name of the function, and by the text we need the length of. Clicking on Enter gives us the result. We fill the whole column with the autofill tool, and we are done. There is a set of functions that help us use part of a text. Such a function is the function LEFT, which returns a specific amount of characters from the beginning of a text string. In order to show the first three characters of the text in column A in the relative cells of column B, we use the function LEFT, followed by the text and the number of characters. In this case, we want three characters. If we only wanted the first character, we could have omitted the second argument, since the default value is 1. We fill the whole column with a function, and we have achieved our goal. Similarly, the function right returns the last characters of a text. In this case, we want the last three characters of the text in column A. So we use the write function followed by the text and the number of characters. The default value for the number of characters is again 1. So if we only need the last character, we can omit this argument. The mid function is a bit more complicated. It returns a part of a text specified by the position of its first character. So in this example, we want to get 4 letters from the text in column A that will begin from the second letter of the text. We type the function's name and the text. Then we have to type the position of our text that we want to extract from, in this case 2, since it is the second character we want to start from. Then we type the number of characters we want to extract, which are 4. We click on Enter and fill the whole column to achieve our final goal. But Excel cannot only extract and split text strings. It can also join them. The function CONCAT, which replaced the concatenate function, joins two or more strings together. In our example, we want to join the surname with a name, with an empty space between them. We use the CONCAT function followed by the surname, the empty space, and finally the name. The result is what we wanted, surname followed by the name with an empty character between them. We could have achieved the same result using the function textJoin. Let's describe the textJoin's functionality using a slightly different example. In cell area A1 to A5, we have a collection of strings. Notice though that one of the cells in this area is empty. We want to join all these text strings together using the space character as a delimiter. But we don't want to include that empty cell. The versatility of textJoin can help us here. We type the name of the function. The first argument is the delimiter, which in our case is the space character. Next, it is the option to ignore the empty cells or not. Since we don't want to include the empty cells, we choose true here. Finally, we select the text range to join. As expected, when we hit enter, we have the required result. This concludes our small walkthrough of all the functions that are included inside the MO-200 Excel Associate exam. Don't forget to visit our channel where you can find examples for almost all functions and features of Excel. We will also be releasing a video with the functions that are included in the MO-201 Excel Expert exam. So click on subscribe and hit the bell button to get notified when that video becomes available.